Okay, so here's a screen porch that's done with little moldings, like mullions. They're screwed and caulked in there. They're gonna come off with some, it's gonna be a fight. I'm taking these guys off and then putting them back in and caulking and repainting them. There'll be something going on there. And this is definitely staple method inside there. So take all of this stuff off, tap those screens down. This is plan number one, and just rebuild it the way that it is now. And I'm gonna pan and make a tally of everything really kind of nice and slow so I see them all. So every single one of these squares is an individual panel to itself. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37. We slide by here. 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. So we have 49 of these panels that minimally need the wood removed, prepped, numbered, painted, and reinstalled with the screen right back into there. That's the most obvious method and how it was designed. Another method might be installing, taking all of these screens out, that's a lot of labor, taking even taking all of those pieces of woods out. They would need to go back even just as a substructure if we put a flat quarter inch mullion over that, painted white, and put a big frame over the top. The more I'm thinking about it, the less I'm liking the big frame idea. Because typical screen porches would have just one panel here with no wood on the inside. One panel here with no wood on the inside. But, I mean, this adds lots of character and detail, having all of this. Also adds to the difficulty. But, you know, that's what intricate stuff is about. All right, it's actually pretty straightforward what needs to be done. There's just lots of it.